And pray for them that they find a true friend. God, in his wisdom, had put together relationships. And part of the package of relationships, he included the wonderful gift of friendship. The world has destroyed this, and they made a mockery of it through the devil himself. But God has laid a foundation for friendship. And you may, during the course of life, have a good friend. If you're fortunate enough, like I am, my best friend is my wife. She's my true friend. Hallelujah. You'll find that God, in his wonderful grace, will give you that opportunity of having friendship. Now, friendship is something that the Bible teaches us, and I want to take you through a couple of scriptures of why friendship is so important. We find in the Bible that the scripture says here in Luke chapter 13, verses 24. Luke 13, 24, I'll just read it to you very quickly. Make every effort to enter through the narrow door, because many, I tell you, will try to enter and will not be able to. Hallelujah. Enter through the narrow door, because many, I tell you, will try to enter and few will get in. I tell you that the people that have the most influence on your life are the ones who are able to speak into your life. Amen. So those that are closest to you will determine who you are. They will influence your thoughts. They will influence your fears. The Bible actually says they will also influence your wisdom. Because the people you hang around with will determine whether you are a fool or a wise person. You hang around fools, you become a fool. You hang around wise people. They speak wisdom into your life. You begin to grow in wisdom. Sometimes you may not find that wisdom in your own family. And then scripture says, Jesus said, I've come to bring fire on the earth. And how our mission was already burning. Because I haven't come to bring peace. He says, this word I have brought, the seed I've come with, is going to turn brother against brother. Mother against daughter. Father against son. Your greatest enemies, this word, will be your own family. Because of the gospel, because you choose Jesus, they will be your adversity. They'll come against you. We find that we look down into history and we find some of the greatest disappointments have been in families. We find them fight, squabble. We see them fight over wills where parents are dying. We see children fight over birthrights. We see siblings fight for what they believe is theirs. And we see in scripture, which I'll take into shortly, that a friend, a true friend, never walks in front of you or behind you, but walks beside you. A friend, a true friend, walks by your side. A true friend is not afraid to correct you when you're wrong. Because a true friend will openly rebuke you to bring correction to your life. Because what drives the friendship is love. And it's down out of love. Sometimes your own brother brother or sister will let you fall, but a good friend will come and even willing for you to hit out at them, to shout at them, scream at that friend. They're willing to take it because they love you that much. That's a true friend. This narrow door that the Bible says we must look at is influenced by people around us. Because people have our ear, they can easily persuade us not to take the route of following Jesus. They can easily take us off that narrow path. That's why who you surround yourself with is very important. Who are your friends? Tell me who your friends are, and I'll tell you who you are. Now, Jesus was interesting the way Jesus done this. Jesus said, he said to the disciples, I no longer call you servants, but I call you friends. That's what he said. But the principle behind it was this. He chose them. So if you look at it carefully, he actually chose his friends. Amen. In other words, you must choose carefully who you keep friendship with. Because bad company corrupts good character. If you're hanging around with the bad and bad friends, you will become a bad person. Let's go through a couple of scriptures here today. Bible says, and I want us just to turn to this very quickly. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 24. Proverbs 18, 24. The man of too many friends, chosen indiscreetly, will be broken in pieces and come to ruin. But there is a true loving friend who is reliable and sticks closer than a brother. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. You know, there are friends in life like David and Jonathan in the Bible that were so closely knitted that David, even after Jonathan was killed, he took in Jonathan's son to uphold an agreement he took with his good friend. Friendship is important. Listen, when you find a good friend, don't break the friendship when they correct you. Don't break it when they disappoint you. A good friend forgives. Hallelujah. The Bible says, a true loving friend is reliable and sticks closer than a brother. You know, there are people who are married and their spouse is not their best friend. Which is very sad. Because your spouse and your marriage should be your best friend. You know why? Let me tell you why. Because friendship allows you to be vulnerable. It allows you to share the deepest things of your heart. Hallelujah. The secret things. You find a friend and you tell your friend the stuff that you're going through. Isn't that true? Because you can't share with anybody, you want to share it in confidence. And so you want to entrust it in the hands of something that you have confidence in that will keep your secrets. That person in marriage should be your spouse. There are others that find friends out of marriage. And for men, they'll find a male friend. For women, they'll find a lady friend who they can speak to. But there's levels that you can discuss with. The Bible says there's a friend that sticks closer than a brother. I love this here. Because brotherhood
seem so intimate.
Oh my gosh. Please, Benji. Brothers, born of the same mother, share the same womb and blood.
It's intimate. But there's a friend that is closer than a brother.
Doesn't share your blood, doesn't share your experiences. And I'm not talking about Jesus Christ, although the scripture is linked to Christ. I'm talking about an earthly friend who is not of your blood, who you can entrust your life. A reliable friend. Let me tell you something. My wife can call me anytime if there's an incident. I drop everything because a friend is reliable. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can't phone a friend and say, they tell me, sorry, I can't make it. Hallelujah. Then they're not a friend. You need a good friend. Let's continue.